Today we're going to discuss about analog and digital communication concepts. Okay, now before discussing going into these topics, the first thing that we have data. So what is a data? Data is a signal which gives a certain amount of information. Okay, it can be of two ways. One is analog data and second one is digital data. Now coming to the analog data, so we can transfer this data into two types of signals. One is analog signal, another one is digital signal. Okay, so we can transmit like in the form of analog signals and digital signals. Now coming to analog signals, like we have two divisions, which is baseband signals. The other one we can call as carrier signals. Okay. Now coming into the digital signals, we have one modulation techniques which is called PCM, okay, which will come later. Now coming to the digital data, it can be also transmitted through analog signals as well as digital signals. Now analog signal, we have three kinds of modulation. Basically, we do follow these three mainly, which is amplitude shift keying, phase shift keying, and frequency shift keying. And coming to the digital representations, we have a number of, famously we will be using Manchester, non-return to zero, or return to zero, and so on. Okay, so this is the basic picture of the communication. Now we'll go a little bit deeper into each of the sections. Now first thing, I want to talk about analog data through which we can transmit through analog and analog signals. Okay, so basically while we are transferring the signals, the main concept comes into the picture is frequency. Why? Because the frequency is indirectly proportional to, or directly proportional to the distance it can travel. If we have a larger frequency, it can travel a large amount of distance. That's why, just give me a second. See, now I'm taking analog data. Okay. So the first one, what I told is baseband signals. So baseband signals are the signals which we having the frequency in range of few hertz. Okay, it is not in 1 gigahertz or in kilohertz. Okay, but coming to the carrier frequency, carrier signals, the characterization of these signals is it has more number of frequency in terms of gigahertz or in kilohertz. Okay, so how we are increasing the frequency of a signal? So the technique with which we increase this frequency is called modulation. Okay, what we are doing is we are taking a baseband signal which is of a low frequency signal, and this signal is we call as message signals. We are having the data in this form. What we are trying to do is we are trying to impose this message signal on the carrier signal which is of a large frequencies. Okay, now that is a large frequency signal which we call carrier signal. Okay, so how we are imposing this message signal onto this carrier signal is our basic concept. Okay, we do have three types of modulation.
The technique is called modulation, which is of three types. One is amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, and last one, phase modulation. Okay, now coming to the first one, what we are doing is we are changing the characteristics of this carrier signal with respect to the message signal. That is the basic concept. Okay, now coming to the amplitude modulation, what we are doing is we are changing the amplitude of this carrier signal with respect to our message signal. Okay, now it will be in this form. Okay, so this is the message signal and it will be having the carrier signal in this way. So as you can observe, the amplitude of the carrier signal is changing according to the message signal. Okay, clear? So that is what you call amplitude modulation. Now coming to other one, frequency modulation. Now in frequency modulation, what we are doing is, as the amplitude increases, okay, see, this is our message signal. Okay, now as the amplitude is increasing, the frequency will be decreased. Okay, as it is decreasing, the frequency varies. Okay, now again it goes. See, likewise, as the amplitude is changing, the frequency varies. Okay, that is what you call frequency modulation. Now coming to the phase modulation, so what will replace the positive peak will be representing by one phase, and the negative peak will be represented by another phase. For example, I'm using zero phase for my positive peak, but at zero, at this junction, there is a change in phase. So that is what you call phase modulation. Okay, so these are the three types of modulation coming to the analog signals. Now what I am doing is, I am taking an analog signal and I am trying to represent it in digital signal. Okay, the process involves two main steps. Okay, what I am trying to do is, I am taking an analog signal or this analog data, and I want to represent it in digital signal. Okay, in order to convert an analog data into a digital signal, we do follow two steps. The first one is what we call sampling, and the second one, quantization. Okay, now sampling is discretization of a time axis. For example, we have a sine wave. Okay, what I'm doing is, in order to represent, instead of representing the continuous wave, I will represent its amplitude at a certain duration of time. Like I'll take the real numbers and I will sample this signal. For example, I'm taking the n value has 1, and the differences between two samples has 1. Okay, So I will take this one, these points at equal distance. Okay. And then what I will do is I will represent this amplitude at this junction. Okay, we are having like this. Again, it is decreasing, so my amplitude will also decrease. At this junction, it is zero. No, it is going negative axis. Okay, so there is what called discretizing in the time axis. This is the sample signal. That is your first step. What I'm trying to do is, as we have a continuous in y-axis and x-axis, first I'm discretizing the x-axis. That process is done. Now what after the second step is discretizing the y-axis. What I will do is, now I have a continuous range, for example 0 volts to 10 volts. Okay, now as you can observe, it is continuously varying. Okay, at each time axis it has some amplitude. Okay, but it is continuously increasing or decreasing. Now what I will do is, I will make few intervals. Okay, let us take off 2 volts. Okay, now the signal, whatever signal which is in between 0 to 2 volts, I will take it as 2 volts. For example, okay, now after drawing the sample signal, okay, and then I will change it to a discretized signal. Okay, now what I will do is, I will represent all the signals which is in between these two range as 2 volts. Okay, so now it will be like this. If you take axis 0, 2 volts, 4 volts. Okay, now just give me a second. So only 0, 2 volts, 4 volts, 6 volts, 8 volts, 10 volts. The rest, okay. Now, this range, these two samples, I will represent as 2 volts. Okay. And this, I will represent as with 4 volts. Again, I have one signal in 6 volts and again 8 volts. Then I'll come down. I have one signal, I have one signal, and this two range, I have two signals, and then I'll go. So I'm converting, or else I can say I'm discretizing the y axis over here. So after these two steps, what we do is, we encode this data and we'll convert all these things into ones and zeros. So that is how we change an analog data into a digital signal. Now, after this one, we do have a digital data. There is another representing the data which is called digital data, right? Now, we can also send this data with the help of analog signals, and other representation is digital signals. Okay, now in this way, in this method, we have mainly three modulations, which is called amplitude shift keying, phase shift keying, and frequency shift keying. Okay, and coming to these, we have more Manchester, non-return to zero, return to zero, and so on. Okay. Now coming to this amplitude shift keying. Amplitude shift keying. What we do is we will take the data which is in a digital form 110110. Let us take. Okay. And I have a carrier signal. What I will do is, so each way, now if I have one, I will represent the signal. For example, I have one over here, two such waves, so I will represent the signal. When we have zero, don't transmit any. Okay, again, if there is one, I will send the signal. When it is zero, I will power it off. In this way, I will transmit my digital data while we are receiving the other end. Okay, if I am detecting any signal, then I will take it as one. But how much duration is based upon the clock signals? Okay, so here the clock is of equal pulses. Okay, so based on that clock signals, I can detect whether it is 1 or 0. That is how we transmit this amplitude shift keying signal and detect. Okay. Now coming to the other modulation technique, which is frequency shift keying. Okay. Now, in this one, frequency shift keying, what I'll do is, okay, it's just like a multiplexer where I will send the signal, okay, and there is a selector, okay, there is a switch over here. To this one, I will send the data, okay. Now here, I can send the two signals. One is of frequency 1 and this is frequency 2 signals. Okay, if this switch is connected to the above, now I will get frequency 1 of 1 frequency, and if the switch is connected to the below 1, I will get another different frequency signal. Okay, now this switching will be depending upon my data. For example, I have 110, I will take the same data, 110. Okay, if this data is 1, then my switch will stick to position number 1. If the data is 0, my switch will be on to position number 2. Likewise, I will be changing the frequency with respect to the data. That is what we call frequency shift keying. Okay. Now, if we observe the output signal for these two ones, the above frequency signal will be selected. Okay. Now, for this zero, I will select the below frequency signal, and which is a little bit more. Again, for the next Rex 2, I will go back to my top frequency signal. And for the last bit, again I will change the frequency. Likewise, I can transmit my carrier signal in which I am embedding this data.